Welcome, friends, to another Turtle Tuesday of Terror. I'm not doing a spooky voice this time because I kind of got a cold, so sorry about that. But today we are doing The Hunchback Leonardo. Let's go ahead and take a peek inside, and he is hideous. Look at that. All right, this is the third figure in the set. Maybe next week we can do April O'Neil, because I was able to find her at Target also. Donatello apparently isn't coming till the spring, so I hear. So I don't know about Splinter. Hopefully we can get them this October. Alrighty. And here we have some cool stuff on the box, such as see what's lurking in the shadows. He has a mind for monsters. Witness the horrifying backstory. Leonardo is the Hunchback. Shell bent on revenge. Katana wielding creature feature. So, is he supposed to be the Hunchback of Notre Dame, or is he supposed to be Igor? I thought he was supposed to be Igor, but nah, they're calling him the Hunchback, so I guess he's Quasimodo. So he comes with this cardboard background, which looks like it's a misty, like dark laboratory. And again, that seems more like Igor than Hunchback of Notre Dame. And here is the figure itself. He is huge. So just like the other monster figures, the amount of detail on this is really impressive. Look at the rope as his belt. Look at the stitches on his skin. Look at everything going on his shell here. In terms of design, everything is just really well done on this figure. Now the articulation on this figure is not very NECA at all, because it's very loose, like easy to move, straight out of the box. You don't have to massage it or anything. And look, the arms are like old school traditional action figure arms going up and down, no ball joints there or anything. Everything else is pretty standard NECA with the knees and everything. Another thing is this is a very lightweight figure. That is because it is hollow. It is hollow because of a storage shell function. We have not seen storage shell turtles for a little while now. It's been a staple of the Playmates toys. We have never seen NECA do it until now. So you open up the shell there and look how much space there is inside to put all of his accessories. Now the hinge the shell is on feels rather delicate to me, and I'm not crazy about it. I don't plan on using it a lot because I'm just afraid of breaking it. Look, there's a spider inside. You can see it. See, there's a spider. That's a neat little detail. And then when you close it, it's this grinding. It makes this grinding sound. I think you gotta like pull it and then close it. Like pull the shell out of the way of the belt and then close it. So that's just something to be careful with. Now let's go over his accessories, starting with his many alternate hands. So by default, he has these open hands. Then he has these two pointing finger hands for, like, you know, conducting music or doing the monster mash. He's got his two closed fist hands for punching people. And he's got his two open gripping hands for holding accessories, which his accessories are just fantastic. I mean, Michelangelo's were good, but Leonardo takes the cake here. He comes with these two shovels for grave robbing, of course, which again is an attribute of Igor, not Quasimodo. And also there's a guideline on the bottom of the box showing you how to put the accessories in the hands. You're supposed to not angle the weapons into his hands. You're supposed to pull the fingers open and put the weapons there. So that might be why I accidentally broke a sai last time with Raphael. So of course he comes with two katanas, as all Leonardo should. However, these have a little more detail. These fun little spike balls at the bottom and stuff like that. And also he came with these cool flames you can put on the swords. So next time Raphael's giving Leo guff, you can get the flames, scare him away. Then he's also got a skull and a bone, which are great accessories for any kind of Halloween setup. And best of all, tell Phineas and Ferb we've located Frankenstein's brain. We got the brain here in a jar, which of course is another iconic accessory for Igor. So I guess it's obvious that this figure is supposed to be Igor, not the Hunchback of Notre Dame. It's just when it says Hunchback on the box, it makes me think Hunchback of Notre Dame, Quasimodo. But yeah, no, it's definitely Igor. And this is probably the best accessory of them all. And here's how it looks with all his accessories all stuffed inside of his shell for storage. And with them in there, close it right up. Oh, I forgot. There we go. and the swords actually are stabbing into his shell and stabbing out the other side. That's funny. I don't think a Leonardo in history has ever had the swords actually stabbing into his shell like that. Now, I just want to really quickly compare him to one of the Playmates ones. Let me see here. Underneath the stage here, I store a lot of old Ninja Turtle figures. And I think there's some storage shell ones in here. Let's see. Is that storage shell Leo right there? Let's
nope. See. Nope, I grabbed the wrong one. This is Olympic Leo.
Oopsies. All right.
Storage shell Leo. All right.
Phew, pardon the dust. On this old figure, had to... Boy, he's always been stiff, hard to open, but there we go. Oh, there's still a ninja star in there. That's how much storage you had in this old one. But this is where, actually Donatello was the first one of these, but these figures is where that concept started of storing accessories in the shell of the turtle. So we can see the concept has really come a long way. Wow. Look how much smaller these old figures are compared to the new ones.
So friends, thank you so much for watching our little review of this Igor Hunchback Leonardo figure. Thank you for tuning in to our Turtly Tuesday of Terror. Have a happy Halloween. Please subscribe if you haven't already, and let us know in the comments section what you think of this Leonardo and of this line of Universal Monster figures as a whole. Have a fantastic day and a happy Halloween. Toast!